Mr. Buckwell, sustainable intensification is a phrase that is recurrent in the European agricultural policy. It's been a couple of years. Would you please explain in broad terms what is sustainable intensification?
The world faces the challenge of feeding another 2 billion people in the next 20 or 30 years. And the question is, how are we going to do that? Are we going to bring new land into cultivation, or are we going to intensify the cultivation of the existing agricultural area? And where I think most observers agree is that it's better to intensify the existing area than to bring new land into cultivation, because if we drain wetlands or we chop down forests, this will cause immense environmental damage, and therefore there will be less damage to the environment if we intensify. However, what we've got to do in the next 20 or 30 years is learn how to improve the environmental performance of that intensive agriculture. So we call that sustainable intensification. Well, Europe is already very intensive. Some of the sophisticated farming in the Po Valley of Italy is amongst the most intensive agriculture in the world. We use a lot of machinery, we use a lot of fertilizers, a lot of crop protection chemicals, a lot of technology, a lot of knowledge. It's already very intensive. So European agriculture will continue that process, but the critical thing is we've got to pay more attention to what are the environmental effects of that. So in Europe, the focus of the attention will be less on further intensification and more on improving the environmental performance.
But what kind of information have we got on this improving environmental performance? Because sometimes it seems that many political decisions in Brussels are taken with no evidence of the environmental impact.
The discussion suggests we must improve environmental performance, but the information and the evidence and the data to support this is not really good enough. This is true. And I think it would help individual farmers to encourage them to do some of their own measurements of environmental performance. How many farmers go out and measure the soil organic matter? How many count the number of worms in the first 25 centimetres or 30 centimetres? We have to devise simple indicators of environmental quality to guide this process. And you're right, at the moment we're a bit in the dark. A lot of the debate in the most recent reform was not helped by the fact that we didn't have the evidence to back up the proposals that the Commission was making. And this is why I think it was understandable that farmers were very reluctant to accept them. In any business, managers can only manage what they've measured. And we're not taking enough measurements of what's the greenhouse gas emissions, what's the leakage of fertilizers into water, what's happening to biodiversity. That we've got to devise simple measures of these things, and that will encourage farmers to manage them. This is the challenge for sustainable intensification in Europe.